So the next one is a few features that I didn't like on first impulse, right? Compared to the A6000 and the A6300. Let's look at them. So there's a few things that I am kind of irritated about. The first one is the layout of these two buttons here. I like the button over here, that makes perfect sense. But before there was a button here, and now there are two buttons over here. Now with the new grip, which is much better to hold, I find if I hold this quite tightly, it's almost impossible to get my finger there. Now I understand that if you change the way that you hold it, like this, then it becomes a lot easier, and probably over time I will adapt to this, let's say, small problem. But it's a bit counterintuitive, because in a way the new grip is so much nicer to hold that it kind of makes sense to hold it tighter, if that makes sense, and then yeah, it doesn't work. Now maybe I'm just putting my thumb here. Maybe the idea is that you use your thumb, but it also doesn't make any... Well, I don't know. I still have to think about, but first impulse, not a fan of that. The second thing that I don't really like is the menu system and the speed of the menu system. I think this might be resolved in a software update, but if we go to the menu... Oh, hold on. If you go to any menu, let's take a random one. Let's take this one. They added animation, so they now animates. Which makes it smaller, and also there's just a little bit more lag everywhere. You also notice it in the menus, right? So if you go to the menu, you sort of, it looks nicer, although I don't think there's a massive amount of change, to be fair, but it does feel a little bit laggy. My gut feeling is this is also the reason why some people have been complaining about the touchscreen being laggy. I think it's kind of related in overall sort of still tuning that they have to do with the software release. I'm guessing that they may be using a different version of Android on top of it. That might be it, but that's something that I also didn't like. And these are the two things that irritates me the most so far. Is the overall kind of a laggy feeling in left and right, and compared to the A6300, and the buttons which are now over here. It's really nice that you have an extra button, but just not totally convinced about the layout as of yet. The third one has to do with, I guess, a positive thing. It has to do with the way that the buffer is being cleared. So let's first go to the A6000 to show you the problem that we were having, which I'm very happy that they resolved with a deep buffer, right? So if I should take a picture, normally if you take fast pictures, or what I quite often do, put it in bracket mode and you take a picture, before you know it, you're sort of having so much pictures in the buffer that you can't access it anymore, right? So let me take two pictures, and because it's in bracket mode, it will take six. One. Oh, it's now a single mode. It was not. Okay, there it goes, because it's really slow, right? But you can see if I now go to preview, it's blocking, right? And it's blocking quite long, and I only took a few pictures. So let's do that again. We can see blocking. Now, one of the major benefits of the deep buffer is, it's a cache, right? So the buffer is kind of decoupling the recording. It's kind of simulating an extremely fast flashcard, which is not there. So it's kind of putting it in a temporary buffer so that other things can continue. So they decoupled the actions. And that's very good, because if I use this one, which is also put in the same mode, and I take the same kind of pictures, you will notice that, it's also a single mode, but let me put it in bracket mode. Hold on. So now it's in bracket mode. And if I take pictures, hold on. Oh, that was timer. Sorry. So bracket mode, and I take quite a few. If I go to the preview, I can preview right away. And here is my problem. You saw that it was showing me how much they still need to write to the buffer. So let's go to the mode that you've seen many times in the reviews, the high speed mode. So let's go for 11 frames a second. So the high plus mode, and here we go. Now the major difference, of course, is that it allows you now to shoot a lot, and you can access it right away. So if we shoot, there it goes. And if I stop, I see nothing. I don't see if that is clearing the buffer. I can turn around and I can see that it's clearing the buffer, but I don't understand why they are not showing me while in recording mode or watching the EVF how much are still need to be written away. Because let's assume that I'm halfway through my buffer, knowing while I'm waiting if I can still press the button and how long I can press it is actually very useful. In fact, it's probably more useful if it tells me the time that I can still hit the button, like 4 seconds, 3 seconds, 1 second. It knows how many shots per second I'm doing, so why doesn't it tell me how much time I still have left? The weird thing, so I have to fill up my buffer again, and then it will go to preview, that it does show you when you are in preview, which is kind of, I wouldn't say useless, but less interesting, because A, I have to go to preview, so I can't do it while I'm shooting and just holding my finger, relaxing my finger once in a while. And the second thing, if the danger is that I take out my battery or my flash card before it's all done, showing me that it's still not done writing all the time actually makes much more sense. So let me show you where it does show you this counter of how far the buffer is being cleared. So again, I'm shooting quite a lot. Then go to this mode, and you can see over here how much it's being written out. I don't understand this thingy majingy at all, to be fair, but I don't understand why it doesn't show me in shooting mode how much it still needs to write to the disk, or even better, what my current buffer is in time, right? Because that would make way more sense to me. So one more detail, and I understand that I'm doing this quite randomly, but one of the big difference I can show you, of course, on the A6300, because it again is recording, but the general improvement of the shutter sound. So listen to this one. It is like a hard sort of clicking noise. And this one almost, it's more like you hear something slide, which is kind of an interesting sort of sound, right? So let me, hold on, it's kind of difficult. So I'll put it in single mode again. So listen to the difference. It's quieter, but also it just sounds more like it's sliding through something. Oh. So it's more dampened clearly, but also it sounds more like it's sliding in something, not like a click sort of sound. So let me think if I can come up with something more for this video, because they're getting more and more random. I guess for now this is it, until I go to the next topic, which most likely will, not even sure how it got here, which most likely will be me looking into the different zoom options and the magnification things, because I think they made a few changes there that I want to compare on the A6300 versus the A6500. So on to the next one.